Hello friends, in today's video I bring a very fascinating topic: how intersex children are born and what is the science behind them. Let's first talk about process of how a typical children is conceived. After intercourse, the male sperm rush to reach in the egg. From the female ovary, an egg is released and enters the fallopian tube. If we look inside the egg, it contains an X chromosome. Male sperm, on the other hand, can carry either an X or Y chromosome. If an X-carrying sperm fertilizes the egg, the result is XX, which means a girl is born. If a Y-carrying sperm fertilizes the egg, the result is XY, leading to the birth of a boy. What happens in this process that leads to the birth of an intersex child instead of a typical boy or girl? Sometimes, an X-carrying sperm about to enter the egg, a part of Y-carrying sperm attached to it and enters the egg as well. This unique situation results in a child whose sexual organs do not develop fully, or males develop female sexual organs and females develop male sexual organs. As you have seen, this is how intersex children are born. Now let's clear up a common confusion. Are intersex and transgender the same, or they are different? This question troubles many people. Before we delve into that, if you have not yet subscribed to our channel, then do subscribe, because we try to explain complex topics related to science with the help of 3D animation. And also press the bell icon so that our video reaches you first. Intersex individuals have physical difference in their sexual organs, as we discussed earlier. But transgender individuals are physically typical boy or girl, but their gender identity differs from their biological sex. For example, a boy might feel that he has girl-like qualities, or a girl might feel boy-like qualities, and they are referred to as transgender. Some may even undergo surgery to align their physical appearance with their gender identity. If a boy loves another boy, he is called gay. If a girl loves another girl, she is called a lesbian. Interestingly, some people are attached to both genders and are called bisexual. There are also individuals who have little to no sexual desire, known as asexual. It is important to note that being asexual is different from celibacy. Asexuality means having no sexual attention or desire for sex, which is due to the body's hormones. On the other hand, in celibacy, people consciously control or suppress their desire, often through practices like yoga. So friends, how did you like today's video? Let us know in the comment. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe to our channel. See you in our next video.